In this tutorial, we're going to create an RGB zoom transition in After Effects, so let's get to it. Here I have a ready composition that has two videos on the timeline. You can see there's no transition, so let's go ahead and create one right now. The first thing we want to do is create an adjustment layer, and the way we create it is go up to Layer, New, Adjustment Layer. Now, what I like to do is trim the adjustment layer down to a desired size. So in this case, I want to make it 20 frames in length. So place the timer indicator between the videos, move 10 frames to the left, bring the start point of the adjustment layer and align it with the timer indicator. Then move it back to the point of the cut and move 10 frames to the right this time and bring the end point of the adjustment layer. Right, by doing that, our adjustment layer is 20 frames in length and we can add our first effect. So we go to Effects and Presets window and search for Transform, then add this to the adjustment layer. And here it's very easy, so move the time indicator at the start of the adjustment layer. In Effect Controls, create a keyframe for scale at 100, then press U key on the keyboard to see the keyframes on the timeline. Move it to the point of the cut, set scale to 300, then move to the end of the adjustment layer and set the scale back to 100. Right, so that gives us simple zoom in and out. Now I'm going to drag and select these keyframes, right click any of them, keyframe assistant easy, so just press F9 as a shortcut. Now while the keyframes are selected, go into the graph editor by clicking here, right click, make sure the edit speed graph is checked, and then select the first point. You'll see these handles, so drag these two handles to the right all the way, like that, and the other handles to the left all the way, so make the graph like peak in this middle point here. Then exit the graph editor. In here we have the zoom transition. So now we need to add motion blur. The way we do that is by unchecking the use composition shutter angle, then set shutter angle to 360. That'll give you a good amount of motion blur, which is key for zoom transitions. After doing that, we can select the adjustment layer, go into edit, duplicate, or press Ctrl D as a shortcut. So for the duplicated adjustment layer at the top, we're going to remove the transform effect, select it, press delete, then search for motion tile in effects and presets. Add motion tile to the top one, then search for tint. Also add this to the top one, then search for emboss. Add it to the top one. Here we need the modes column. So if you don't see the modes column, click toggle switches and modes until you do, and set the top adjustment layer's mode to hard light. Right, nothing changed yet. Now we're going to move to the start of the adjustment layer. Here we're going to set map black to a red color, then map white to say this blue, click OK here. And for the emboss, we're going to create a keyframe for relief at the start of the timeline and set relief to 0. Now move to the point of the cut between the videos, increase the relief, and as you do that, you can see we get these RGB effects applied to the footage. So I'm going to set this one to say 25, then move to the end of the adjustment layer and set relief back to 0. Then press U key to see the keyframes, drag and select them all. Press F9 to easy ease them. Again, go into the graph editor and do the same thing. Drag these two handles to the right all the way and the other handles to the left all the way. So create the same kind of graph, then exit the graph editor and preview the transition. And that's how quickly and easily you can create an RGB zoom transition in After Effects. I hope you enjoyed and learned something new in this tutorial. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Peace out.